everybody, it is Coltrane Z from EC Gaming, and today I got a little review on the Elgato Game Capture HD. I got it a couple days ago, and ever since then, things have been going really good. So first, I just want to show you the setup real quick. You got the HDMI out, and you plug the USB into your computer, and then you got the HDMI and the AV cable. Since I use HDMIs for my Xbox 360, I use the AV cable for the PS3, because there's this little HDMI non-piracy deal, and that was kind of weird, but anyway, even the AV cable is really easy to set up. And also, you see, it's a very small device. I recommend it if you're like traveling a lot. You can just slip this in your pocket and then do some capturing on the go. And I have these plugged into both consoles, like I said, so there's not a lot of cords. You don't have to plug it into any power source except for your computer. So as long as you got your computer on and it plugged in to the USB, then it's all gonna be good and you're ready to capture. And then here is the software over here. It's very user friendly. And another reason I got this over the HD PVR, or actually I recommend this over the HD PVR 2, because I used to capture with the HD PVR 2, and I'm gonna tell you some of the reasons now. Number one, you can live commentate, and this saves me a lot of time when I'm doing Let's Plays and stuff, because when I used the HD PVR 2, I used to have to go back and commentate. And another reason is, when you talk, it automatically reduces the game sound. So this is always helpful, because when I used the HD PVR 2, I would always do my commentaries, and sometimes I would forget to edit the audio with the game and then my voice. So then when I would upload it, the game would be way louder than my voice. You couldn't hear me. It would be really annoying. I would have to take the videos down and then re-upload it again after I edit it. And then another reason is playback mode. I can't really show you guys exactly what it is right now, because I don't have any of my consoles on. But what it is, basically, if you forget to press capture, it just captures in real time for you. And I think it's up to 2 hours. So you just scroll back here. And if you forget, like say I have a good game on Call of Duty, all I have to do is scroll back and I can see that game. And then once you're at the point you're at right now, it's just live, so it captures in real time. So that's always helpful. I didn't have to use it yet because I always press capture. And also, you can live stream to YouTube and Twitch. You used to only be able to live stream to Twitch. They had a little update, so now you can live stream to YouTube. And that's really cool, because I never did I haven't done a live stream yet. And I'm thinking about doing one when The Last of Us comes out. So I'm just messing around with that right now, testing out a little bit. And then also, there's something really cool. Once you have all these cords plugged into the platforms you want to capture on, you never have to unplug them again. I capture with the PS3 and Xbox 360. So say I'm done capturing with the Xbox 360 and I want to go to the PS3. I don't have to unplug anything. All I have to do is turn on the console, press PlayStation 3, put it to the resolution that I desire, press OK, and then bam, I can start capturing for the PS3, and then all I have to do to go back, Xbox 360, OK, and it's as simple as that. So it's very user-friendly, easy to capture. You can basically get done anything you want with both consoles. It's pretty easy to multitask if you have both consoles on. And then here is the editing part of the software. This is also very user friendly. These are all the videos I made so far. I did Dragon Blood Part 5 using the Elgato, and then I got some Call of Duty clips that I'm gonna be posting tomorrow. And once you're done capturing, unfortunately, you cannot do a pre-recorded live commentary. So if I don't do a live com, I can't commentate on here like I could with the Apache. That's one downside, but it's pretty easy. All you have to do is export it to Movie Maker, and you can just click on it right here and it brings it there. And also, if you did do a live commentary, you can upload it to YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Apple TV, iPod, iPhone, or you can export it in MP4 original, MP4 1080p if you want to download it with a different software. And it's just very helpful because they have all the platforms right there for you, and it's very easy. So that basically finishes up this review for you guys today. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.